O ye of little faith, fear the Lord. Hurricane Ian. I want to give all the honor, glory, and praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem Rabbah HaKodash. Dub on some elders at Great Millstone, singing us to the elect, peace and blessings to the one third. Right now, I'm at my aunt's house with my younger brother, so I haven't been able to do sit downs the way I want to. You know, but now that it's nighttime, I'm taking over the shift in the front of the house. It's giving me a little time to speak on faith. And the reason why I'm making this quick video is because I'm down here in Tampa, Florida. Well, I'm in St. Pete now, which is like 30 minutes from Tampa. And I was going to ride out by myself, the hurricane. But my aunt asked me, did she want me to come over? And I said, if you're requesting, I will accompany you. If not, I'm going to ride it out. And she said, yeah, I want you to. I wouldn't want to be over here by myself, nervous if the power goes out, you know. So, no, go ahead, bro. Go ahead. It's in the kitchen. So, hold on, pardon. So, lock in. So I came down here to stay with her, and she was asking me, you want to go to Orlando? You know, because they say it's going to be, you know, surges of 9 feet, 10 feet, you know. And I was like, auntie, when I came over here, I was like, auntie, you go to church, you believe in God. She was holy, she really believe in God, Christian. And she know, you know, white folks, or what she call them, white folks, you know how they be slimy and snakes and all that. But where she works at, she been cleaning condos for decades, and they love her to death, you know. But I was like, auntie, I said, auntie, what was your faith? You told some, you know, leaving St. Pete to go to Orlando. I said, if it's his will, it's going to be his will. Fast forward, because this was like yesterday, 24 hours ago. Fast forward to the day, we've been getting a lot of rain, a lot of wind, but okay, the power's off, but we have plenty of supplies for energy and food, things like that. And now the hurricane is heading directly towards Orlando. And that's the reason why I'm making this quick video. Because when Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai made their entrance to the earth to redeem the nation of Israel, the elect at first, and to get rid of all things that will offend in the kingdom, these people out here are going to be bugged out. They're going to be scared. Because I love natural disasters. Why? They always remind mankind that there's a higher power out there than you. And that's what this hurricane showed. That's what an avalanche would show. An earthquake. A mudslide. A lightning bolt. You know, because I just got an update saying now it's one of the strongest hurricanes in the world. I mean, on record. But once again, this is Hebrews 11 and 1. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So I was hoping for the best and prepared for the worst, but to run away or move, or, you know, I can understand evacuating. That's different. Don't be over righteous. Don't destroy that. So, but she wanted to go to another city where she thought she could avoid it, when it's going to be on a direct path there now. And we just like, the Lord blessed us. You can see on the screen, the purple dot is where we're at. So it was supposed to be like a direct hit, but the Lord is kind of swivel it over. But that don't mean anything, because there's other brothers here in Florida that believe as well. Other brothers in Orlando, Miami, all over. But this is just a prime example of what faith truly is. I was going to ride it out either way. You can't go against the will of the Most High. You know, I remember, I think it was Charlie, people left from Tampa to Orlando, and they thought they were the hurricane. The hurricane did a loop. I remember that. I remember that hurricane did a loop. So even when we speak of famines that are coming, race wars that are coming, the pestilence, Revelation 13, the mark of the beast, you know, A day like no other on earth, you know, Daniel 12:1. When we speak of, you know, the slain of the Lord shall be many. The Lord gonna judge all flesh by fire. And remember, the Lord also said, 1,000 shall die by thy side, and the evil shall not touch us. Roughly paraphrasing, right? But that's the mentality of having faith. We hope that we are part of the elect. That's why we say we're the hopeful elect. So in order for you to be saved, you must have faith as well. What happened when Yahweh Shai? Matter of fact, let me get it. Prime example. Let me give you an example. Example of faith saving someone. This is Matthew 8:23. And when he was entered into a ship, his disciples followed him. And behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea. Like a hurricane is a tempest that forms in the sea, right? Okay. Insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. Man, Yahusha had to be sleeping real good. And his disciples came to him and awoke him, saying, Lord, save us, we perish. He saith unto them, why are ye fearful, O ye of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. But the men marveled, saying, what manner of man is this that even the winds and the sea obey him? Let that sink in. So you who are faithful, all right, and those who could be affected by this hurricane, you know, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai control the tempests, the waters. Remember in Jeremiah, the 5th chapter, the Lord said, fear ye not me, who said they bound for the sea, that the waves or the water cannot pass. That's why we don't get flooded. Because the Lord set a decree for the waters not to overflood us. He made a decree. So if there's ever a flash flood or a tsunami, a tidal wave, that's the Lord. So that's why I wasn't going to go anywhere. I'm going to hold my faith. And you should always keep that same mentality in any and everything. Because remember, it's His will. It's their will. You cannot go against that. You cannot run from judgment. You cannot. Because the Lord can just take your spirit like that. I just saw a live update saying that Coolio the rapper passed away. Did he know? I mean, I'm just saying in general, like, that he know exactly. We don't know. We don't know. We don't know where we're going to be born. We don't know where we may leave this earth. Because some of us may not see death. You know, but nonetheless, though. Right? So, another example of faith. And I'm going to close out really quick. Matthew 14:20. Beautiful. Man, it's a lesson. I'm going to get on to me. This is Matthew 14:22. And straightway, Yahweh Shai constrained his disciples to get into a ship and to go before him unto the other side, while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. So they already set sail. Yahweh Shai is by himself. He spent a lot of time by himself meditating. Verse 24. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Yahweh Shai went unto them, walking on the sea. Pay attention. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a spirit. And they cried out for fear. But straightway Yahweh Shai spake unto them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. Here comes the point, a test of faith. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. And he said, come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Yahweh Shai. But when he saw the wind boisterous, meaning it was picking up, he was afraid. Listen, what happens when he became afraid and beginning to sink? He cried, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Yahawashah stretched forth his hand and caught him and said unto him, O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? And when they were come unto the ship, the wind ceased. Then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, Of a truth, thou art the Son of God. So if you believe Yahawashah to be the Son of God, if you believe in Yahweh, Bahashim Yahawashah, if you believe you have the Ruach HaKodesh, alright, you have nothing to fear. Because Yahawashah is our faith. If you have to believe that he will save in times of need. Because when he became afraid, because the wind picked up, that meaning he started to lose a little faith. And he started to lose his foundation of walking on the water. And Yahawashah was like, oh, ye little faith. But remember, having the faith of a mustard seed. If you just had the faith of a mustard seed, you could pick up the sycamore tree and plant it in the sea. They mean that with God, anything's possible. With man, damn near impossible. If it be of Yahweh, it will come. If it come to Yahweh, it will stand. If it come from man, it will come to naught. Right? So with that being said, pray you was edified and fed. Stay in the spirit. Don't fear it. Just endure it. Ask for forgiveness. Pray without ceasing. Stay humble. Remain diligent. Quamesha Allah. Waflababal. Shalom.